Welcome to the Catalyst Sale Podcast with Mike and Mike. Sales is a thinking process. This podcast will help you learn about what works in sales, how to hone your skills, and increase your success. I'm your host, Jody Mayberry, and I actually have a question this week for Mike and Mike. So listener questions will have to wait. Mike and Mike, I'm bringing something forward here because I've heard you two talk quite a bit back and forth about SSI scores on LinkedIn. And so I use LinkedIn. I got on there and looked for my SSI score and I did not see one. So I have a two-part question. Where is my SSI score? And maybe I feel weird asking you guys this because you talk about it like I should know. What is an SSI score?
So the SSI score. So yeah, I'm trying to think when we, this must have been like in a pre-recording session or something when we were just going back and forth about it. And I think it's coming back to me a little bit. I think it was, I was giving Mike a hard time because his score was on the rise and he was giving me a hard time because my score was on the decline. And we were both feeling pride in the fact that our scores were heading in those directions. So Jody, what we'll do is we'll send you the link. There's actually a link that you can use on LinkedIn and we'll put that in the show notes as well about how anybody can click on that and then discover what their social selling index is, what SSI stands for. It's basically a metric that LinkedIn has created that sales reps and sales leaders, in some cases, have really gravitated towards assessing how effective they are as salespeople. And I think that's where Mike and I sort of have a lot of discussions around to see what is the SSI score and does anybody have any real data to demonstrate that there's not just correlation between results and selling with the SSI score? Is it really causation? What is it that's really driving those scores? And does it really pan out? And I think one of the things, this is actually good timing because one of the things that I've talked to Mike about is, could we actually do that study, you know, as Catalyst to say, we really want to understand the SSI score. From one perspective, you could look at it and say it's nothing more than a gamification element of LinkedIn, or it's just a vanity metric that basically LinkedIn has done a good job of getting people to use their platform, which then generates a higher score. So on that front, it's brilliant. But then the cynic in me looks at it and says, but is it driving the right behavior that's actually delivering the result that you want to see from a sales rep? And my hypothesis is that there might be a score that's too high. In other words, you're doing a lot of activity to get your score up in LinkedIn, but at the end of the day, is it adding value and is it helping you become a more effective sales professional?
Sounds like you're speaking from the perspective of someone who may not be in the top 1% in SSI scores.
I think I'm in the 2%. I will openly admit that my score has ranged anywhere from the low 50s. I think right now it's at 56. I think the highest it ever went was about 92, and that was some time ago. But they do change the algorithm, it appears, within that in that metric. And so you never really know exactly what you need to do to optimize your score. But it's pretty clear there are times that they'll introduce new caveats to help drive score, things like posting video, engaging in groups. So you kind of have an idea of what the four categories are of the SSI, but you don't know the exact algorithm and what it is that you have to do to drive that score up. But I've had a pretty wide range. And right now I think I'm at a steady 56. And I think my partner in crime here is, what are you, like 88?
84.
Yeah, and not that he's bragging, but 84.
Yeah. It's not, you know, I mean, to Mike's point, it's not something, I don't know that it's really something to brag about. I mean, usually when I get excited about performance from a sales rep perspective, it's a percent of plan, it's revenue that they generated, it's those numbers. I mean, it's, yeah, what did it actually impact from a dollars generated perspective? But the four groups are establish your professional brand, find the right people, so connecting with the right people, find the right people, meaning you're identifying those who you should be, who you would want to work with, engage with insights, and build relationships. And that build relationships is tied to a strengthening the network connection that you have with decision makers. And what this has done for me, and I'm sure LinkedIn has all the data, is they see me going in and poking around and checking my SSI score because I'm a competitive SOB. And I just, you know, I like seeing where the numbers are going. But to Mike's point, the question we've got is, how does it actually impact sales? Like, how does it impact performance? How does it impact revenue? How does it impact the success of a team? If the team has a high SSI score, does that mean they really work well together as an organization? They work well, they're perceived as being value-added resources by their customer base? Or is this just another example of gamification drawing people into a specific idea and concept?
So on that note, I know I was joking about bragging your score is so high. Would you be impressed? Would you have any thoughts at all if someone on your team, you found out they had a SSI score of 90 or something impressive? Would it matter at all to you?
It's not something that I look at and say, oh, wow, that person's doing a great job. In fact, I can tell you from, and the reason that I'd love to get feedback from other sales leaders is I've actually correlated that higher score with activity that is driving the score, but not activity that's driving, you know, building relationships or uncovering opportunity or moving deals forward. In other words, I have seen cases where the rep feels like they're doing a great job because they have, and there's a leaderboard in your Sales Navigator. If you have Sales Navigator, it'll show your team members and the leaderboard and things like that. And I think that's where it crosses a line where if that's what they're measuring, that's where they're going to spend their time. And if they know that, hey, I've got to go in and comment on more discussion threads, or if, hey, my score is right now, it's really low with connecting with the right people. So I'm going to send out a bunch of invitations to people with C-level titles, which, you know, I've had one rep that got himself in trouble because he said, hey, I've got to, you know, I've got to connect with more people. And he went out and sent out a bunch of, you know, invitations to people that he didn't know, didn't have a good basis for engaging with, and then ended up getting flagged in LinkedIn by, you know, sort of being a bad custodian or a bad member by basically spamming people with invites. So it can be a, and that's what we want to really figure out. My personal experience has been, if you're focused on that and you're in the 90s, you're probably spending a lot of time on LinkedIn spinning your wheels. And I'd love to see data either prove me wrong or show me what is the optimal score. You know, if you're in the mid 80s, that says you're using the tool wisely, you're connecting with people, you're doing all the things that are positive, and you're also seeing results. And LinkedIn doesn't show you the effectiveness of a sales rep, it shows you the effectiveness of using the tool. I'd like to be able to link those two things together.
Yeah, so we'll make a survey available on the website, and we'll send it out to, you know, folks who've connected with us. And we're going to ask you for, you know, just a couple of things. One, your SSI score. Two, performance versus plan, you know, in the last measurable period. And we've got to be careful about, you know, how we ask and how we gather that information. But another thing that we'll do is we'll ask for feedback. And that feedback will be something to the effect of, how has the SSI score changed your behavior? And we'll ask, how has the SSI score changed your behavior? And is it impacting results? And it'll be good feedback, not only from the individual reps, but also sales leaders in general. So we'll split out the results based on that. It'll be kind of neat to see the data. I know when I go in and I take a look, I see if I'm kind of dropping down in an area, that's a, it's a good trigger, a good reminder that maybe I need to do a little bit more here on this side. But on the opposite side of that equation, the, you know, the doing bad things, you know, a sales rep can feel like they're really doing a lot of good stuff by liking a lot of content in LinkedIn or commenting on a lot of content in LinkedIn and doing the things that will drive that number up, creating a perception that they're actually working. The reality is they're more like a washing machine. They're just going through the motions. They're not doing the hard stuff, which is contacting their customers, picking up the phone and talking to people. And ultimately, you know, that's what works in sales, is the direct engagement that you have with others.
Well, this has been a good conversation about this, because I really didn't know what to think of the SSI score. I'm kind of nervous. I'm going to look when we're done talking and it's going to be 12. But this is really interesting. I'm glad you're doing that survey. Mike Connor, do you have any final thoughts to add or anything you want to input about the survey?
No, I would just say that by the time this airs, we'll have the link on our website. We'll have that survey developed that Mike talked about. We'd love to gather feedback. We'll probably use this recording as a way to sort of promote the awareness of what we're up to and what the objective is of doing a study like this. So if you want to stay informed with the progress, anybody that participates, obviously will provide the information back to that community, and would be really thankful for anybody that participates and eager to see what we can learn. So just keep an eye on catalystsale.com And usually on LinkedIn and Twitter, we'll promote that as well.
All right. Thank you so much, Mike and Mike, for answering my question. And let me remind you, if you have a question you would like Mike and Mike to answer, it can be something like this. LinkedIn, what is the SSI score? Just anything you're wondering about in your career, about sales, just go ahead and send us an email to hello@catalystsale.com and we will add it to the lineup for a future episode. Thanks again, Mike and Mike, and thank you for listening to the Catalyst Sale Podcast.